packaging and transport of dry blood spot samples. The blood spot has been collected, the TRRF form has been filled, and the consent has been taken before that, and the sample has been collected on the card, on a appropriately, properly labeled card. So what are the materials that are required? Again, powderless gloves, glassine paper. Glassine paper is nothing but butter paper. This kind of a butter paper that is used at below the baking when somebody is baking. So this kind of a paper that is used. And then desiccant sachets, humidity indicator cards. I will show you a humidity indicator card. This is what a humidity indicator card looks. When everything, all conditions are dry, it'll be blue. When it is not dry, it'll turn pink. So it should at all. So humidity indicator cards and biohazard labels, blank labels, plain paper envelopes, self-addressed envelopes, padded envelopes, stapler pen. So these are some of the things that will be required at the time of packaging. Till such time, now you know that I've just said that the samples have to be posted every Tuesday. So if every day one or two samples are collected, what should be done is that
here is the card which has a sample on it. It should be made to dry, and it should be put, after it is dry, it has to be put in this. A Ziploc bag needs to be taken. In the Ziploc bag, put a humidity indicator. Put 3-4 sachets. This is the bag, Ziploc bag, humidity indicator. Silica gel sachets. Put it in. Put this dried previous card, sample card, in glassine paper. One glassine paper envelope for each card. Put it in this. Actually, it is
supposed to be put in a cool, dry place, but we've had instances and people have reported that ants ate up while it was drying, or if it was left outside, or you know, rat bit the ate up the paper. So what we suggested, yes, put it in the fridge. That is what you will tell the LTs. But they must ensure that twice a week they need to check the humidity indicator card, and it should be blue. If it is not, they will take it out, change the humidity indicator card, take out the silica sachets inside so that the conditions are dry in this. So they are packaging and storing. So it says specimen is not to be immediately, if the specimen is not to be immediately transported, keep the DBS packaged in sealable plastic bags, refrigerated at 2 to 8 degrees centigrade. What is very, very important is that the DBS card with the sample should not be coming in contact with the plastic of the Ziploc bags. It always has to be in this envelope, as you will see in the video. Sometimes when these envelopes are not available, just cut bits of it of the butter paper and fold it in the front and behind the card, as you will see in the video. So it should not touch the plastic. And do not freeze is very, very important. Each such Ziploc bag carrying the specimens must have pasted on it a biohazard sticker. So what this should have pasted on it is a bio, because a lot of other people are going to open that refrigerator and they should know that what sample is there in this. So they should have a biohazard sticker on this. And if today I have put one card, there should be a sticker, label stickers on it. I should write on that the unique infant code of the card that I have put in it. Supposing tomorrow I put two, then two more stickers, or one big sticker should be there in which I keep on adding the unique infant code of the card, so that on the last day or the day of couriering, I don't have to open it, take it out, keep on checking what is the card, and then make a delivery checklist. Because then I won't have to handle it. It'll be, if my 5 cards per this, okay? If my 5 cards are in it, on top, I have that the unique infant codes of the 5 cards and the date of collection written on top. So this is how it should be. And a sticker specifying the identity, I'm reading the second over here. Sticker specifying the identity of the specimen enclosed in that Ziploc bag. This information may be used to tally with the TRRF form. Because what you're going to send to the lab are the cards. For each card inside that Ziploc bag, the TRRF form that you're going to be sending and the delivery checklist. So you can have your TRR forms out. Today is the day that you're going to give it to the courier. Problems that they see with the samples that are sent to them. So file the TRRF forms separately until required to be packaged in an envelope to go along with the specimens at the time of handing over the specimen to the courier. 2 copies of the TRRF will accompany the specimens to the testing lab, and 1 copy, which is the last copy, the yellow one, will be retained at the ICTC. Okay, so check the color of the humidity indicator twice a week. Now this is when the cards are still in your refrigerator. Check it twice a week, anytime during storage or before packaging for handling over to the courier. If you notice a pinkish tinge in the blue circles of the humidity indicator card, change the card and replace the moist silica sachet with a fresh dry silica sachet. You can recharge the humidity indicator card in this way by putting it in hot air oven at 65 degrees C. Okay, until the pink spots turn blue and you can reuse them. In case the specimen is to be handed over to the courier or mail, pull out the storage package from the refrigerator 1 hour before the next or the final steps of packaging. When contents have come to the normal room temperature, 20 to 25 degrees C, place a Ziploc bag containing the DBS inside an envelope. So how are you going to package? Now what you're going to do is,
this is my Ziploc bag, and in each bag I can have put up to 5 cards. The humidity indicator card is there, the silica gel sachets are there. So what I do is that I have this one envelope with this. I'm going to put all the 5 cards in here. I can post more than 5 cards also, but in different Ziploc bag, right? I can pull 15, so I'll have 3 Ziploc bags. So all that, so what you do is you take another envelope which will be provided to you. In this you will put all the 5 or 15, whatever number you put, the TRRF forms and 1 delivery checklist, right? And you fold it, this together. And you take another envelope that is given to you. On this you will put your address of the ICTC. Phone number, contact, all this should be put. So that a critical call out can be made if there is a positive, and usually the reports go back through courier. So, but we want to start ART as fast as possible to a child who turns out to be positive or who is detected. So what a self-addressed envelope with the contact telephone number or email of the ICTC should be a blank envelope, self-addressed. There's no need to put stamps. The testing labs are paid. They have a contingency from which they will post it, right? So this, so all these 3 things, an envelope with the TRRF and the delivery checklist, a self-addressed envelope and a Ziploc bag containing the DBS card. DBS card is inside the glassy envelope, silica gel, and the humidity indicator card. All this is put in a larger padded envelope together. All of it is inside. Because of the regulations of the of transport of biohazard, you need to put a biohazard sticker on the top. The address of the laboratory should be written very, very clearly, right? And this is how it gets courier. From my inquiry, people use all kind of couriers. The post is very good, reliable, good, and samples. Usually, you also allow them to see. So, this is how, here is a kind of a small biohazard label. We have larger ones also, so depending on, you need to have some of these labels on, you know, on the Ziploc pouch which has the cards also. So this is how it has to be packaged and storage.
So use a reliable and tested courier mailing system for transportation of the specimen and packages. The center must dispatch these collected specimens to the testing laboratory on every Tuesday of the month. If Tuesday is a holiday, as I said, it is going to be dispatched on Wednesday. And take care to keep the DBS free from moisture and humidity. Postal and local transport regulations must be followed if using the postal or courier, which is majority that you have to indicate that it is a biohazard material inside by putting the sticker on top. So these are the labs. These lab testing labs, samples from which states that come to them are put on the, so for your own state, you when you are training, you will tell them the address, which is there in the next slide. So these are the addresses who are lab in charges, PCR testing labs. Dry blood spot specimen collection. So counseling should be done, consent form should be, have been filled. Make the child comfortable, fill out the records, that is the TRRF forms and the DBS card. Ensure availability of all materials required for collection, prepare for collection, wash hands, wear gloves, etc. Collect the dry blood spot specimen, dry and package, store and transport as instructed, and send it to the testing laboratory. Okay, one thing that you need to reiterate to the LT is the supply chain management, which is very important, that all these things that will be supplied by SACS or by NACO, that they need to verify things when they receive, they need to know, so that there is no instance or no time when the materials are not available and that they are not able to take samples. There can be problems from our side also, but we will all together try our best to see that there is no hitch in the program. So why it is a very, you know it all, that why inventory management is important. So these are just the points that you will tell them, that it avoids use of expired items, it minimizes wastage and relocations. Relocations cost a lot of money also, and ensures availability of materials and kits when needed. So it means, inventory management means knowing what and how much stock is there at that particular ICTC of the materials, when to order fresh supplies, what and how much has been ordered, when it was ordered, all this record should be maintained over there, when the supplies were stored and when and how much fresh stock was received, and the name of the person and not just a signature of the person who receives this. I have to tell you this, many of you will be having CD4 labs associated with you. We have throughout all the time, NACO does not give payment to the suppliers because consignee receipts certificate, the CRC as we call it, is not legible. Now there are certain rules and regulations of signing the CRC. They have to be filled up in a particular manner in blocks, etc. And the signature should not be illegible. It should be the name of the person in running hand and a stamp below. So all of us have to do our best and follow so that there's the program runs smoothly. So inventory management, perform a stock count, maintain proper inventory records, determine when to reorder, determine how much to reorder, placing orders properly, inspecting delivery of new orders, and ensuring proper storage. Okay, when the on receipt of the supplies, they need to verify the contents of order received, check integrity of samples, that they are all right, expiry dates and date on each item, store new supplies behind. Even the DBS cards have an expiry, by the way. And create or update the records as it should be done. Next, okay. So the key messages is, of course, to maintain an adequate stock at all time at ICTCs of these materials and order or tell in advance, and of course, and have an inventory and inspect what is being received. So this is DBS card monthly stock report that from the site. When I say site level, I mean the ICTCs. The soft copy will be given to you. The ICTCs will have to fill it up, and by the 7th of every month, they should send it to their respective SACs of the stock, how much they have, how much they began with, how much they relocated, how much they use, etc., and what is left at them. By the 7th of every month, they need to send it to their respective SACs so that they can compile. Because our orders, when we purchase DBS cards, there is an estimate happens that how many positive pregnant women have registered at the ICTCs. Then we presume that they will all have live births. So, for example, it was 35,000 last year, so 35,000 live births. Then each child will, we say that will come three times for the dry blood spot sample, and there can be a repeated testing. So there are tools that we have that we calculate how many DBS cards will be required. And we are not able to purchase DBS cards off the shelf. So they need to be really ordered well in time. And they have an expiry also, so we can't even buy too many and keep just because it is paper. So all this is very critical, and of course it is expensive, that's another matter.